And today I am going to explain you about complex numbers and complex functions. So before going to explain you about complex numbers, I would like to introduce with real numbers. So real numbers include 0, 1, minus 1, 2, 2.15, and I can keep on listing the real numbers with which you all are familiar. But the question arises when I get a square of some number as negative. For example, if I need to find the square root of minus 16, so this I can write as 16. Under root of 16, under root of minus 1. But I know the square root of 16. But what about this under root of minus 1? So for this, the concept of complex numbers, that is the imaginary numbers, is arised. Now, the imaginary numbers are defined as I minus I 2.1 I pi I EI and so on. Here one variable is introduced, that is I. Yes. Imaginary unit whose value is accepted as I square is equals to minus 1. So I can get I is equals to under root of minus 1. Now combine this real number and imaginary number, then I get a new number like z is equals to, suppose I take from real number 1, then 1 plus from here 2.1 I. So 2.1 I. So this z is called the complex number. But the 1 is called the real part of that number. So 1 is a real part. And 2.1 is the imaginary part. So if someone asks you that what is the real part of Z, so you can write in the real part of Z is equals to 1 and the imaginary part of Z is equals to 2.1. Now we know that it is a tradition to represent normal numbers in the Cartesian plane. So there is one provision for complex numbers also. So we represent them in the complex plane. Like in the normal case, we represent the horizontal axis as real axis, real, and the vertical axis as imaginary. So if I want to represent a complex number, suppose z is equals to 3 plus 4 I. So for the real part it is 3. So I will equal to 1, 2, and 3. So 3 will be real. And for the 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you can visualize the complex number z right over here. Now, this z is having some distance from the origin. This is called the modulus of the z, and we denote it as r or mod z also. And the angle which the modulus makes with the x-axis, we denote it as theta, which is called the argument of z. So if you write it over here, r is equals to modulus of z, which will be equals to the under root of 3 square plus 4 square. So 3
3 square plus 4 square, which will be equal to 5. And the theta, that is argument of z, will be equal to tan inverse of imaginary part, that is 4, upon real part, that is 3. So we can find the argument as well as modulus of any complex number. After studying complex numbers, now let us cover complex functions. Let us take one complex variable z is equal to x plus y, where x and y are the real variable and z is complex variable. Let us take another complex variable w is equal to u plus i, where u and v are real numbers. Now, for every value of z in a plane, if we get for each value of z in a complex plane in a specific region, if we get a one and only one value of variable w, then I can write it as w as a function of z for all values of for a specific region of z. Now let us take one example to understand this. If you use this variable z and w, then I define that the w is, we are adding the value of w for each and every value of z, and w is given by z square minus z. So I can write it as z is equal to x plus y minus x plus y. So by expanding this, x square here and 2xy plus x square y square minus x minus y. Now we know that y square is minus 1. So we can write it as x square plus I 2xy minus y square minus x minus I. And we know that what is the w? W is u plus I. So that will be equal to x square plus I 2xy minus y square minus x minus I. If we compare the real and imaginary parts, then we get u is equal to x square minus y square minus x, and g is equal